The video is titled, Dogecoin Will Take Over the World, and he has a lot of important things to say about Dogecoin.
Can you describe why Dogecoin is going to win? Which it surely will. Like, it very likely will take over the world, and once we expand out into the universe, we'll take over the universe. Like, what are your thoughts on the recent success of Dogecoin, where you've spoken to sort of the meme stocks, the memetics of the whole thing? It feels like the joke can become the reality. Like, the meme, the joke has power in this world.
Yeah.
It's fascinating.
Something very interesting happened. Lex Friedman commented, "This tweet is not about Bitcoin. Not everything is about Bitcoin. Or is it?" This was followed up with a reply from Elon Musk, stating, "Sometimes it's about Doge." Followed up with another reply from Elon Musk and Lex Friedman, with someone stating, "It's always about Dogecoin. We love you, Elon." And of course, that had to be followed up with a tweet from Elon Musk. So why is this so important for Dogecoin? In order to answer that question, we need to first understand who Lex Friedman is. Lex Friedman is both a student and a YouTuber with over 1 million subscribers. We can see that he is an AI scientist, and he is a researcher working on autonomous vehicles, human-robot interaction, and machine learning at MIT. He has interviewed Vitalik Buterin, who is the founder of Ethereum. As we can see here, Vitalik Buterin is a Russian-Canadian programmer and writer who is best known as a co-founder of Ethereum. So Lex Friedman has a lot of influence and is very engaged in the cryptocurrency space. Dogecoin is a joke, but in the fact that Dogecoin was first started out as a meme actually holds a lot of significance and power. And a lot of this is actually undershined by the fact that Dogecoin was first started out as a joke. So it's very easy to look over Dogecoin and disregard it as a joke.
Exactly. It's like, why is it correlated with Elon tweeting about it?
It's not just Elon alone tweeting, right? It's like Elon tweeting, and that becomes a catalyst for everybody on the internet kind of like spreading the joke, right?
Exactly.
The joke of it. So it's the initial spark of the fire for a Wall Street Bets type of situation.
Yeah.
And that's fascinating because jokes seem to spread faster than other mechanisms. Like,
yeah.
Funny shit is very effective at captivating the discourse on the internet.
So we can see that when people do not believe in something, they undervalue the potential of that particular thing to the point that it is completely disregarded. And I think that this is a huge mistake.
I think you can have, I like the one meme, like Doge. I haven't heard that name in a long time.
Yeah.
I think back to that meme often. That's like funny.
Yeah.
And every time I think back to it, there's a little probability that I might
buy some
Dogecoin.
Right? Yeah.
And so I imagine you just have millions of people who have had all these great jokes told to them. And every now and then they reminisce, oh, that was really funny. And then they're like, let me buy some.
This is Will Rogers. He is essentially the living embodiment of Dogecoin. He is funny, he is likable, and most of all, he is an underdog. In 1928, he ran for the presidency in a mock campaign. And it wasn't so funny when the mock campaign in which he had ran for presidency actually won him the presidency, in which he immediately resigned. This shows that there is a lot of value in being seen as a joke, because people overshadow the potential of that particular person or thing.
Wouldn't that be interesting if, like, the entirety, if we travel in time, like multiple centuries, where the entirety of the communication of the human species is like humor? Like, it's all just jokes. Like, we're high on probably some really advanced drugs. And we're all just laughing nonstop. It's a weird, like, dystopian future of just humor.
Lex Friedman, a student at MIT, has realized this mistake that people are engaging in. And Elon Musk, a genius with an IQ of over 160, the founder of PayPal, and the man that has started both SpaceX, Tesla, The Boring Company, and Neuralink, a brain implant company that is revolutionizing the world and allowing people who are disabled to no longer be disabled and actually continue living their lives in a normal way. The likes of Elon Musk can only be compared to Nikola Tesla, Albert Einstein, and others. Therefore, these highly intelligent people see something that others don't in Dogecoin, and that is saying a lot. Do not undermine the value of what it means to be a joke, because we have seen with Bitcoin that people have a tendency to overshadow it to the point that it is extremely undervalued. So while others undershadow the value of Dogecoin, we have the likes of Elon Musk and Lex Friedman who see the potential in Dogecoin being seen as a joke. Dogecoin is the Will Rogers of cryptocurrencies. When people hear Dogecoin, they immediately think of a meme coin or a joke. They don't actually see the potential that Dogecoin has. They don't see the fundamentals of Dogecoin. It's essentially like an invisible mask that hides the potential that Dogecoin has. It's a lot like Will Rogers and the fact that people did not believe that there was a sliver of a chance that Will Rogers could actually win the presidency. And in that case, Dogecoin is the Will Rogers of cryptocurrencies. And when Mark Cuban has something to say, when he has $24 billion US dollars, you listen. So when Mark Cuban says Dogecoin can reach a dollar, you listen.
Or Mark Cuban never calls time out.
I always look at business as a sport. And in football, you play 60 minutes. Basketball, you play 48 minutes. In business, it's 24/7/365, and the whole world's trying to kick your ass.
I will never forget talking to Mark about, you know, where are you going with this broadcast thing? And he goes, I'm going to the BBC, Billionaire Boys Club.
Mark Cuban parlayed his passion for Indiana basketball into a company worth $5.7 billion.
The day that Broadcast.com was sold to Yahoo, I think a lot of folks felt like we had hit the lottery twice.
Over the last 20 years, I've always been about what's new, what's next, and how am I getting there first?
Well, you guys heard it. What's new? What's next? And how am I getting there first? And man, he was first to Dogecoin. And I think a year from now, we're going to have the other 30 NBA teams using Dogecoin as a form of transactions. And maybe a year from now, Dogecoin can be worth over a dollar. Because what's new and what's next is Dogecoin. And here we have Mark Cuban's Dallas Mavericks acceptance of Dogecoin. Sparse crypto debate. What's a joke coin? Is Dogecoin a joke or is it very serious? Are we just a little too new to this trend? And we don't see the potential in Dogecoin? Or is it the next big thing that could be used as a form of transactions all over the world in all sports games, including the NBA, including the NFL? Now we know that Bitcoin may have been a joke to some back in 2009. Now if you were to own Bitcoin in 2009 and held onto your initial investment of $10,000 or more, well hey, you have no concerns in life and you are a multi-millionaire. And let's say $500,000. Well, hey, you have $500 million. So it goes without saying that Bitcoin was seen as a joke, but it no longer is a joke since it does retain its value as the economy constantly inflates. So Mark Cuban is new to Dogecoin and he sees potential in Dogecoin and he sees that Dogecoin is what's new, what's next, and it could be used as a form of transactions all over the world. And Mark Cuban is filthy rich. We're talking ridiculously rich, $23.4 billion. And last time I checked, his net worth it was around $4 billion. So he is investing. He has 6x'd his money. So he is a great investor, and when Mark Cuban has something to say, when he has $24 billion US dollars, you listen. So when Mark Cuban says Dogecoin can reach a dollar, you listen. But who else sees something in Dogecoin? Well, if you look at the richest addresses in Dogecoin, there are a lot of people who see something in Dogecoin that are filthy rich. We have someone worth $2 billion, 30% of all Dogecoin. What does this person know about Dogecoin? Where does he or she see Dogecoin headed in the future? Where do these 11 addresses who own 20% of all Dogecoin see Dogecoin headed in the future? What do they know that the average investor doesn't know? And what does Mark Cuban know that the average investor doesn't know? Well, they know Dogecoin is going to take off in terms of digital transactions, in terms of decentralized currency, in terms of being what's new and what is next. And I do think that Dogecoin can outperform the dollar. Since Dogecoin, as of now, it does have a relatively high inflation rate, around 4%. However, the general trend, as Dogecoin keeps getting printed, and once it does reach that market supply of around 200 billion Dogecoin, with over 5 billion Doge printed each year, the general trend is actually declining. And eventually, in the future, that general trend will reach a plateau. And once it plateaus, we're talking about an inflation rate of less than 1%. And once it does reach that market supply, we're talking about an inflation rate of 0%. So Dogecoin does have the potential to retain value and therefore be a highly effective use or method in terms of transactions, especially in digital currency.
Let's talk about blockchain. To me, that is actually a non-proprietary utility,
right?
Why would that in any way be a storage of value, blockchain?
Anybody can use it. Blockchain effectively is software.
Okay, I mean, so
it's a distributed database that's managed independently, and that inherent combination makes it a utility, makes it software effectively that has value and utility.
So when somebody's running around trying to raise a blockchain fund, that's just a software for hire fund.
And in some respects, you know, but there's a specific there are very unique use cases for blockchain. So for instance, when people say there's no value at no intrinsic value to crypto, they don't really look at the value of blockchain. Now, when you take blockchains from different types of cryptocurrency, Bitcoin versus Ethereum versus others, there's significant differences, but blockchain in general does have at least a basic intrinsic value. Not as high as what the cryptos trade for, but there is basic intrinsic value. And I'll give you an example. If, for instance, there was a blockchain-driven general ledger system that had auditing capabilities.
Yeah.
So, for instance, for a big company, you wanted to have a truly independent auditor that would... So you would set up a general ledger system using blockchains where an external third party would be able to look at different segments of the general ledger. There wouldn't just be one auditor. You could have
it makes the process more efficient, so it has value there.
Well, but it makes it not just more efficient, but it makes it truly independent.
But there's no equity that I can buy in blockchain.
Well, but let me finish. Imagine if this was a system used for Enron.
Yeah.
So that instead of having Arthur Anderson doing their auditing and their accounting, and we know what happened from there, the auditors and the accountants, there were three different auditors and accountants that just using blockchain were able to look at a specific segment of their general ledger.
So they would have caught the fraud way earlier.
They would have caught the fraud because you couldn't fake out all three of them.
So it has utility there. I get that.
Well, there you have it. Mark Cuban and his philosophy on both blockchain and cryptocurrencies, which are directly in correlation. Now, Mark Cuban sees value and potential in blockchain and cryptocurrencies, and he stated that it does have intrinsic value. So along with those cryptocurrencies, including Bitcoin, Ethereum, Dogecoin also has the potential to have intrinsic value as a form of transactions. So we know that Mark Cuban has invested in hundreds of successful companies to date. And him allowing the trade of Dogecoin in the NBA to be used as a form of transactions with BitPay is not such a small feat. He is the first to do this. The first in the NBA. And he is also the largest merchant of Dogecoin. And that is not going to stay for long. Those 20,000 Doge in transactions is going to change. It's going to be millions. It's going to be billions, and it's only a matter of time before this does occur. So in the 1990s, we know that he absolutely saw potential in the dot-com era and founded several companies and sold them. He founded these startups and sold them to help him reach his billionaire status. And honestly, I do think if he does invest into cryptocurrencies, he's going to be well worth over $100 billion. And we're going to see a lot of people worth $100 billion if they do invest into cryptocurrencies. So crypto is going to make people millionaires, and it's going to turn millionaires into billionaires. And here we have Mark Cuban, a billionaire who could be $100 billionaire. So that's a lot of money. But other than that, my point is, Mark Cuban has always seen potential in these niches before other people did. And he knew what was new, what was next, before other people did. He was first. And when you are first, before the tsunami, before this wave of people who begin to invest in something that they see potential in, but you already seen potential in it and you invested before them, well, hey, your money goes up. That is why Mark Cuban is a great investor, and that is why he sees potential in Dogecoin. So although people think Dogecoin is a joke now, it will not be a joke for much longer, when it could potentially outperform the dollar. And with the viewership of over 7 million people in the NBA just watching from their TVs, and with thousands of people attending these games, I do think that Dogecoin is going to rapidly expand, and it's going to rapidly become a form of transactions. And with the inflation rate going lower and lower with each year that passes in Dogecoin, then the general trend is that Dogecoin does have the possibility to outperform the dollar, since fiat currency is directly controlled by the government, whereas Dogecoin is decentralized. And there are 30 teams in the NBA, and only one of them has accepted Dogecoin. I think that is also going to change. So we could have all of these teams accept Dogecoin. Mark Cuban was the first. He was the first to see Dogecoin as what's new, what's next, and he thinks Dogecoin can reach a dollar, and I absolutely do agree with him. Now, I don't think Dogecoin is going to reach a dollar overnight. We have to be realistic here. If that is to occur, Dogecoin will need a market cap of $100 billion. We're looking at $120 billion for Dogecoin to reach a dollar. So that's not going to happen overnight. But can it happen over the course of a year? Yes, that is entirely feasible. But what's more realistic is that as Dogecoin continues to expand, when it creates more opportunities like these, the general trend is that Dogecoin is improving and expanding, and therefore increasing its share price and market cap. And in the future, we could have a $1 Dogecoin. Are you interested in making big money with cryptocurrencies and you want to take your investing to the next level, but you don't know where to get started? The difference between sitting at home on a couch and living your dream life could potentially be by becoming a Patreon. We have daily 100x altcoin picks that involve a lot of risk, but a lot of potential to turn $10,000 into $1 million. It's time to make a change in our lives, and I'm here to guide you in that path. With just a $5 investment, you can take your crypto investing to the next level. This is a limited time offer. What if I told you that there was a guaranteed way that you could make free money? And it's exactly the same thing as purchasing a lottery ticket, with higher chances of you winning thousands of dollars. For a limited time, Webull is offering 2 free stocks, and all you have to do is sign up. The clock is ticking, and they won't be doing this for much longer. Link in bio.